In this household, we stand for the flag. But some flags just make you want to sit back down, bend forward, and start spewing. I'm Austin from Johannes Factotum, here with the top 10 worst state flags from the United States. This list includes state flag iterations from all across U.S. history, so we dug deep to find the worst of the worst. Let's go! Starting off this list at number 10, we have the Western Wonderland where the buffalo are roaming, Wyoming. Now, I know this one is going to piss off a lot of people, so we're going to get it out of the way. And to be honest, it's not a bad design overall. It's clean, it's simple, it gets the job done. But I just can't ignore that OCD eyesore that is the state's great seal fighting to escape its bison enclosure. If you're going to go through the trouble of smacking it right in the middle, the least you could do is hit a line to center. But no, they wanted it to be as big as possible. Or as big as they could make it by pushing its edges tangentially against the bison. What makes this all the worse is centering the seal seems to have been the plan from the get-go. The original design shows the seal placed centered while still within the bison, and later iterations led to the off-center mess we have today. So close. At number 9, we have our first vintage flag, being the 1861 Civil War flag for Alabama. And oh boy, bless their hearts, they sure had a lot to say with this flag. So much so that they had to make a backside to fit all their thoughts onto this thing. You've got Lady Liberty, a call to secession, their stubborn reason for secession, a rendition of the classic Get Off My Ass Mom Snake, and a flag of their country, which I think we can all see here, is not their flag. This is their flag. They did not have a flag before this. They came up with a simple and concise flag design and decided it wasn't enough. We need more flag on our flag. This design was discontinued in 1865 for case of, inaccuracy.
Away down south in the land of traitors, rattlesnakes and alligators, right away,
right away,
come away,
come away,
right away.
Looks like we've rolled that lucky number 7, it's Nevada, baby. Nevada's had a few iterations of their flag throughout the years. It started with the silver and gold star-studded sensation, then it was revamped to this lovely football layout. But by 1929, the Raiders hadn't won a single championship, so they came to this design with the Battleborn emblem on the corner. But wait, that's not what the flag looked like before 1991. Oh, there it is. See, Nevada isn't like the other kids. They write their name Fun. This is what the artist in the class in third grade does to the birthday cards he hand makes for his best friends. They like to write their name in a crazy circle at the corner of the page, hoping the teacher notices and gives them an extra pity point on their essay for creativity. But colleges aren't going to accept an admissions letter like that, so they need to learn to write in a straight line. I could go on about the drab, reciprocated look that states default to by putting their state seal in the center of the plain, navy blue flag. And if they're daring today, sprawl their name across it to show you how original they are. None of them are particularly great, but for the sake of repetition, the one I'll be signaling out for number 6 is Montana. First off, this is their state seal, a beautiful mountainscape above a riverside plain, with tools showing off the agricultural significance of such an alluring view, and the hatching and color palette make it quite spectacular to view as a patch or a print. Why wouldn't they want to display it on their flag? Well, they did. And it looks like they pulled out all the stops to recreate it miraculously on the finest copy of MS Paint they could find. Seriously, all the artistry in this piece has all but disappeared. Everything's been crudely traced and filled in with the closest match that unmixed swatches of paint can muster. Yes, grass is green. This green is kind of like that grass. I mean, it's the only green we have left after using the other one on all the trees. Bastardized seal aside, they had the gall to add the state name, just in case seeing the flag flying in the state of Montana wasn't clue enough. The flag didn't even have the name before 1981. They just decided to slap it on there after 76 years like they were renewing their IP before copyright ran out, just so they could keep it. Don't look at me, Montana, you can have it. Coming in at number 5, it's the only 10 I see, it's Tennessee. But this is no 10 out of 10, see? The state's first official flag set out to be audacious and forward-thinking by incorporating forward slashes to separate the staple red, white, and blue colors. That's cool, the state itself is slanty like that. Anything else we can add? How about a number? Cause we're the 16th state, that's something. Oh, and our state has a strong history of military service. We could be proud of that. Let's proclaim we're the Volunteer State. Should we show some military symbolism, maybe like a soldier or a musket? Nah, let's just spell it out for everyone. The forward-thinking symbolism is asking enough of people's critical thinking skills, wouldn't you say? That doesn't really fit comfortably on the design. No, no, can't make it too small. No one would be able to read that. Let's just move it right here. Hey, that fits. I'd say we've successfully conveyed everything we need to say about Tennessee here. Oh, it's past noon already. Anyone up for a Cracker Barrel?
Away down south in the land of traitors, rattlesnakes and alligators, right away,
right away,
come away, come away, right away.
And number three, we have a tree. It was Massachusetts' first flag after the country's independence in 1776, and I guess it said all it needed to say. The Appeal to Heaven declares the new country's desire for separation of church and state, which 250 years later, people still seem to be figuring out what that means. And then we have the tree. It's just a tree. You drew a tree on a white flag. This is the best you could come up with? George Washington sat his ass down, looked around and saw trees and said, "Ah, a tree." And that's what we got, a tree. And on the back, look, it's another tree. This flag was adopted as Massachusetts' naval ensign and stayed that way until 1971, where they just ditched the text so that everyone could focus better on the tree. Oh, your state has trees? So does f***ing all of them. Don't get too blue, it's number two with Vermont. And we're not looking at the current state flag, which has a tree, but we're going all the way back to before the state's first officially recognized flag in 1804 to see what the Green Mountain Boys were flying in those years. Here we have the original, unofficial flag of the Vermont Republic, and can you tell it took them 5 minutes to design this? Here we've got the breathtaking blue on green palette that takes heavy inspiration from the colors that you see while looking slightly up at the sky, the saturated hues of which look like the same color if you squint your eyes enough. And then you gotta pay homage to the great 13 colonies you're fighting for. But what, someone already found a way to organize 13 stars in a circle that looks put together and professional? No, there's no time. Dump the cutouts you already got and we'll glue them where they land. Ah, it's like looking into a real night sky. But hey, for Mrs. Johnson's first grade art class, you certainly show that you didn't get any help from your parents on this one. B+. Before we get to our number one worst state, let's go through some honorable mentions I couldn't go with not talking about. Iowa. This one is just a crude early iteration of Iowa's current flag, without the red and the blue. And the eagle clearly has no body in this one. Angry Birds looking ass. Maine. This was a temporary flag used by Maine for their bicentennial celebration in 2020, following a failed attempt to adopt a similar design for the official state flag. The accepted design sports the ever-recognizable tree, a staple of Maine and quite possibly only Maine, and rocks the popular green-on-blue color scheme, infallible as it is. This one has nothing to do with the US. It's the flag of the European Federalist Movement that preceded the present-day EU. I just had to show you because I thought it was so funny that it's just... At number one, we have a state I can't believe I'm mentioning on this list, New Mexico. Before we reveal the flag that represented this state for 10 of its first 13 years, let's look at its first and only official flag that stands as the number one best flag of the United States. It's clean, it's concise, it pays respect to the state's rich heritage of the native people here. It doesn't have anything to say in words. There's no literal picturesque symbolism. It doesn't share the red, white, and blue of 90% of the other state flags. It establishes itself as unique and overwhelmingly succeeds. 3 years after being admitted as an official state of the US, New Mexico found itself in a pickle at the San Diego World's Fair in 1915. They had no flag to display next to all the other states in the exhibit hall. The mayor of Santa Fe, Ralph Emerson Twitchell, not wanting to make a fool of himself in front of the other cool states, decided to display a little number of his own doing. The flag he hand-designed and displayed at the World Fair was this. There's so much to go over here. Every part of this is a complete disaster. We start with the flag of the United States cleverly snuck into the top left corner, signifying that, yes, this is a state of the United States of America. Which state exactly? Why, it's New Mexico, of course, written in bold serif lettering that subtly tapers away as if you're slowly falling asleep just being here. We have the state number in the top right corner, coming in at number 47 out of 50, giving off major participation trophy vibes. And finally, we have the state seal slid into the southeast corner, proudly stating in a half circle wrapped text around it that this is the Sunshine State. But wait, South Dakota is displaying their flag in the same exhibit hall, and their flag claims that they are the Sunshine State. They designed their flag 6 years ago, but it turns out that nobody's correct, because Florida butts into the conversation and declares itself the official Sunshine State in 1970. So not only is New Mexico not the Sunshine State, but this flag also sucks major nards. This is the most baffling design for a flag I've ever seen. And while it's not even an official flag, it still stood as the representation of the state for a whole 10 years, and sits on display at the Palace of the Governors in Santa Fe today. I think the only thing it's missing is another item to place in the bottom left to really make this flag the busybody it's trying to be. Well, at least everyone loves a good comeback story. That was our list of the top 10 worst state flags throughout US history. Go ahead and hop into the comments below to scream at me for putting your state on the list. And remember to never give up on your dreams. Anyone can be a graphic designer, as long as you apply yourself and work for your local government. You know, I might run for state senator with something like this. What do you guys think?